then we know that searching for a job is a full-time job, and sometimes it can be stressful. And in that sense, what tips you have for job seekers in terms of staying calm during job search? And is it okay to have kind of a calendar or a program to follow so that they can do not just 8 hours of job search, they should do other things also?
That's a great question. Well, let me back it up a second here. When you're currently employed in a particular role, I don't think your job search should be ending either. I think one of the key tenets about job searching is that you should be continuously curious about job opportunities. And so what does that basically mean? Well, first of all, I believe in the adage, my network is my net worth. And so I would be continuously building up the rapport with my network, making sure that I continue to let them know what I'm interested in, what I'm good at, deliverables I've done in the past, you know, how I've been successful. And, you know, there's all kinds of different roles out there, but that you can articulate a sense of your success in that network through just little hints and little drops. And just, you know, again, I believe that the network is like a garden. You tend to it, you water it, you fertilize it, you build it, and you reap benefits. Yeah. So I don't believe, just to be clear, that you're in a job and then you're in job search. I think you're always in a job search. Mm-hmm. And that in part is enabled by the network point that I made.
Yes.
Now, when you're, let's say, unemployed or you're between roles. Mm-hmm. Now, I don't believe in the word panic either. I don't think anyone should panic, because the fact of the matter is, if you have articulated yourself well enough in social media, whether it's LinkedIn or otherwise, in that network, in the way in which you're building your CV so that it's articulate, I don't get the sense that you should be panicking as an individual if you've done your homework. If you've sat back, if you're not tending to that garden, if you will, yeah, you might panic. But that's not a situation I want you to get in. I want you to think about the advice first of what I just mentioned. Now, I'll also say this, that just because a job comes your way, I wouldn't necessarily grab it. Mm-hmm. And again, that presupposes that you don't need the income per se right away immediately.
Yes.
Now, if you do, that's a different story. But Mher, what I'm getting at is, again, I find more often than not, when people jump at that first job offer out of panic, often there's second guessing going on. And it may not be the best role, best fit, just because it came first. So again, always use your lens of who am I, what am I trying to be, how am I going to get there? And if it's not quite solid a fit, plus obviously the organization and role purpose questions we talked about in another episode, those are key points I want you to consider and think about. So bottom line is, don't panic, but tend to your garden as often as you can in order not to get into a panic-filled situation.
Yeah. I totally agree with you, especially here in Vancouver. We are all about networking, who you know. And that's how I landed my first HR job. I knew someone that knew someone and they were offering. And then he just made me an introduction and that was it. The rest was on me. But I also feel that when I was working full time, I was getting some, you know, are you open to communication or open to open? I was always like, yeah, let me try. You know, let's see what's out there. If it fits and it's good, why not, right?
Absolutely. I mean, at the end of the day, whether it's Vancouver, Montreal, Toronto, LA, New York, wherever, Chicago, London, Paris, you can always get a job.
Yeah.
Right? I really believe, like, if you need a job, you can get a job. But if you want a purpose-based role,
yeah,
then again, you're gonna fight for that. You gotta tend to that. You gotta go grab that. You gotta go position yourself for things like that, rather than just wait for it to appear. So jobs will appear. Fantastic.
Yeah.
Purpose-driven, purpose-related roles that are impactful to you, that you need to play a little more aggressive, you know, athletic Olympics with, if you will.
Thank you for those great tips, Dan. And again, for the audience watching or listening, if you have any other tips in terms of staying calm during job search or any other job search tips, please leave it in the comment section below and tune in next time for another great question with Dan.